friends, you are watching Bhavishya and I am your host AP. Friends, today we are going to discuss about the experiment that name is Linear Control System using Optical Fiber Communication System. Okay, basically this experiment is very similar to the our telemetry experiment and the circuit diagram is also same. The extra part in this circuit diagram is only this buffer circuit. Okay, so see how to connect this buffer circuit. This buffer circuit is connected before the transmitter. So let me show you. See here, this is my transmitter circuit of the telemetry. This is my receiver circuit and this first part is our buffer circuit. Okay, see, in telemetry at the place of this 10 kilo ohm resistor we used thermistor, but here we directly used one 10 kilo ohm resistor. So remove that thermistor and used this 10 kilo ohm resistor. So let me show you the circuit diagram recalling once again your telemetry circuit diagram for a receiver and a transmitter, transmitter or a receiver. So this is this is the circuit diagram for the transmitter and this is for the receiver. So in this linear control system, at the place of this thermistor we used 10 kilo ohm resistor. Okay, here you can see this is 10 kilo ohm resistor, and at the place of this RB we used this 10k pot. This 10k pot is for our requirement, means how to how we want this waveform. Okay, and here this is our actually 10k pot, and this 10k pot is used for the variation of the control voltage at the pin number 5 of this transmitter. Okay, so let's discuss about this buffer circuit. Here 1741 we used here, 1741 from here 2 to 6, 1 kilo ohm resistor is connected, and this RI also 1 kilo ohm. This RI as well as RF is 1 kilo because we want our gain 1. So as we know the gain formula, according gain formula, we want this gain 1. So we place this RI and RF as 1 kilo ohm. And here we used this 10k pot, and here 10 kilo ohm resistor, and here 4.7 kilo picofarad, or you can use 0.1 microfarad capacitor. Okay, this buffer circuit is used to protect this transmitter circuit. If you provide the signal directly to this transmitter circuit, it may burn or it may affected by this current or voltage directly. So to the protection and the variation of this voltage at the pin number 5 we used this buffer. Okay, so let's take the circuit analysis, and according to this circuit analysis what the observation we have to take, it's on the CRO. Let's see. So here our buffer circuit, this is our transmitter and our receiver. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to just connect the power supply, as we connected all this power supply and ground both side. So connect this power supply here and the negative minus VCC which required for this op amp we connect here, and this is ground for common. Okay, now let's see what will be the waveform. So let's start. The voltage 12 volt and the output is taken at the pin number 3 of the receiver. So for the output, what you have to do, you have to just connect this transmitter circuit. So for this output taken from the pin number 3 of this receiver circuit, and for this we have to connect, as we connected in telemetry, this from transmitter to receiver, from pin number 3 of the transmitter
to the base of this transistor, okay, and now take the output from here. Now what is the use of this 10k pot? So let me show you. For that you can use to increase or decrease your width of the wave. So here you can see clearly the T off or T on can be varied by this 10k pot. Okay, so means according to you what or how output you want, you can vary. So that purpose I used here. Now the most important things, what you have to do, you have to maintain the output or output voltage 5 volt at this transmitter. So let's check it's maintained or not, as we maintain in our telemetry circuit. So here you can see it's maintained 5 volt per division. So you can see one division multiply the 5, that is the 5 volt. So at transmitter this 5 volt is maintained. Now you have to take reading from the receiver, and for that just connect it here and take the reading from pin number 3. And the most important part of this experiment, you have to vary the voltage of the pin number 5 by using this pot, and that voltage should be between the 1/3 of the VCC to 2/3 of the VCC. As we applied VCC 12 volt, so 1/3 of the VCC is 4 and 2/3 is 8. So our output voltage at pin number 5, minimum voltage should be above the 4 volt or 4 volt, and maximum it will 8, 9, 10, whatever. So let's see what is the voltage at the pin number 5. So for that I'm going to connect this DMM. So let connect this DMM at pin number 5 and ground, and let's see. Here you can see when this pot is minimum, the observed voltage is 4.31. Now let's come to the observation table. So you will clear what to do. See, in observation table you have to vary this voltage at the pin number 5. So control voltage we named as a V control, and you have to determine this mark time, that is the T on, this square time, space time, this is the T off. So as we know, this is our T on and this is our T off. Okay, so let's see how it's vary according to your this 10k pot. You can adjust it. So let it for a stable, it's like this. If I adjusting this, and according to this you have to note down the reading. So let's vary this voltage at pin number 5. Here you can see how the space time and mark time changes. So at 4.32, this is the position of the wave. At it's very sensitive for few volts, so move very lightly. Okay, so at 5.35 the position is like this, and the frequency is 94. Now here you can see the frequency is 94 hertz. Now let increase the voltage. So at 6, here you can see the frequency is 83, and this is our T off and this is T on. So as you increase the voltage at the pin number 5, you will find that your frequency is decreasing and your T off is fixed and T on will vary. correspondingly. Okay, so let's see the last reading at 7.38, or if you increase here, you can see your T on is increasing, T off is remains constant, and frequency is simultaneously changing. Now the same procedure you have to do with optical link. This all observation is without optical link, and the same procedure you have to do with optical link. And for that, as we used in telemetry, the optical kit, you have to use that kit, and the same procedure you have to repeat. Okay, so, and the last one things, if you plot the graph, actually you have to plot this graph also, and not only here but also at the pin number 6 of this the graph of pin number 6 of this transmitter circuit, that is the along the capacitor, you have to also measure or draw. So here the charging and discharging of the capacitor you can see clearly, and let me stop it. So here you can see, okay, if you increase the voltage, you will more clearly you can see. Okay, so this graph you have to draw. Now so after taking all observation, what you have to do, you have to just determine this V average without optical link, and V average with optical link. For that, the formula is T on divided by T. So T on, our mark time, divided by the total time without optical link, and T on and multiply by also V naught or VCC. Okay, so by determining this all, you have to draw the graph. See, this graph is along the capacitor. This is our stable graph. Okay, and the main thing is, main graph is this. You will get a linear graph. So this graph is average voltage versus time period, and when you will draw it, whatever the average voltage you get here, after determining this, you have to draw and you will get a straight line graph. So this is the main purpose of this experiment. Thank you.